Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at using Find and Replace in TextEdit and other apps. So Find and Replace is a tool I use all the time, and I take it for granted, but a lot of people don't know about it or don't use it. You can find it in most word processing apps. I'm going to demonstrate here first in TextEdit. And I've loaded in the Project Gutenberg version of Call of the Wild. So I have a very large document here. And say I wanted to universally replace something throughout. Well, first I'll start with Find, and then I'll look at Find and Replace, and then I'll look at Find and Replace All to do it all in one shot. So to find something, I would go first to Edit and then Find. Now it's going to be in a slightly different place in different apps. Sometimes there's an entire Find or Search menu all by itself, but here it's an Edit. And I've got Find and some other similar commands. Let me just start with Find here because I can get to everything through there. And this will actually bring up a toolbar here at the top where I can type some text and then I will get some results. So let me type in the word dog. As you can imagine in this book, it appears a lot. And you can see actually right here it says 198, so 198 times. So now I can actually use these arrows to go through them. So I can go to the next one and just keep going and look at all the instances of the word dog, or at least those three letters together, dog, and see them. So there it even finds dogs because I'm searching for those three letters. So it's going to find them inside of that word. Now you don't just have to use these arrows. You can actually use keyboard shortcuts. If you look under Find, you can see that Find Next and Find Previous, Command G and Shift Command G will allow you to do this really quickly. So I'm just going to Command G through the document. And you can see I can just jump around looking for maybe the one instance of this word that I wanted to change or get to so I can edit something else nearby. And Shift Command G will go backwards through the document. So using those shortcuts, you can jump around and look for what you need. So say if you're searching for something and there's only seven of them and you know that there's something you want to change near one of those, you can just do a Command F, type the word, hit return to find the first one, and then Command G to go to the second one, third one, fourth one, etc. Alright, so now let's suppose I want to change all of these. Well, what I can do here is I can check off this replace box here, and now I get a second field and I can replace it with something. So fun, let's replace dog with cat. Now I can hit two buttons here, replace or replace all. If I replace, you see it changed that one and it automatically jumps to the next one. So now I can continue to use replace and go through them all. And this actually will help because if I wanted to skip one, like say skip this one, I can hit the next arrow there and then just replace the next one. So if you want to change some but not all instances of a set of letters, you can do it using these two buttons here. Likewise, you could just go and say all and it will replace all of them that are present in the entire document. Now you saw how it would find the letters DOG inside of another word and would find those and also replace those. So I could do something a little more precision here. If I search for cat, I see the 33 things come up and I don't remember there being any cats in the book, but you could see right here it just found it in the word scattering, scatter, and other words. So I can click here on the options and you can see I get lots of different options like ignore case wrap around, which means that if you're at the end of the document it will wrap around and continue to search at the beginning of the document. I can look for words that contains, starts with, or has to be the full word. So let's try that full word here for cat and you can see there's two of them. So you can see there's one and there's two. So there actually are two instances here where the word cat appears. And sure enough, since I'm doing something here where I'm looking for the entire word, I want to look for cats as well. None of those. So there's just two of these. Now a technique I use, say if I wanted to replace all of the dogs with cats, I could do that and it would leave these two instances of cat in place. So what I probably want to do is first search for cats. Say if I wanted to change cats to dogs, I could search for cat, replace cat with something like that, four asterisks after it, and replace all. So now you can see I've changed it to be this. So now if I were to go and change all the dogs, and let's take off four words here, dog to cat, I can replace all. And if I search for cat, you can see I can find those two instances now, and I can change those both to dog. So now I've got the cats and the dogs switched. Now TextEdit actually has some very powerful search functions. I can go into the options here and I can insert pattern. So for instance, let's say I want to search for all the words that end, that start with the letter B and end with K. So I'm going to type the letter B here and then I'm going to insert a pattern and I'm going to, first let's insert any character and then K. And now it will find any group of letters that start with B and end with K. B and K. B and K. So I don't want that. I want to actually just have a word that starts with B and ends with K. So I can go to full word here. And now, sure enough, there I go and I've got instances of buck, there's back, and any other word that would fit that. And I've got a whole bunch of different things I can insert here. Word breaks, white spaces, single digits. I can even just search for an email address or URL. So for instance, let's do a URL here, erase this part of it. And you'll see that actually it can find several URLs inside of this text. I have to turn off full word here. And now it should come up and there you go. Sure enough, there is some URLs there in the header information for this. So there's all sorts of different things that I can search for. Let's see if there are any email addresses in here. And indeed there are two. So you've got a lot of power here if you get to know these. It's not as complex as using what's called grep by programmers who can search using other apps for very complex strings. But you can do some very basic things in here if you play around with these and figure out what they can do. You can also insert special characters like tabs and line breaks and things like that. So you could find, say, words that are at the end of a line by looking for the word and then ending with line break or paragraph break. Now looking in Pages, you've got a similar thing here. Find actually will bring up a little movable window and you can search for things and it will show you the number found and you can page through them. You can switch over to replace and it, just a different arrangement, but it's basically the same thing. Replace all, replace and find, or just replace and stay in that current location. But you don't have as many options. You can do whole words or match case or not, but you can't do all the special search functions in Pages. In Microsoft Word you've got the basic find command, which brings up a very simple way to find, and then you can also do find and replace. But you also have the advanced find and replace. And here you can do things like actually have wildcards. If you check off use wildcards, put asterisks there. You've got lots of different options. You've also got the ability to find with formatting in place and styles and things like that. So you can find words that are particular styles and all sorts of things. It's a pretty deep, comprehensive find and replace as you would expect to find in Word. Find and replace isn't restricted to just word processors. For instance, here in Keynote, we find that it has exactly the same functionality as it does in Pages. So you can find and replace some of the basic stuff. But if you have a big presentation and you need to replace something throughout it, or just search through all those items to find something, you can do the same thing here as you can in Pages.